Sydney Football Stadium, completed in 2022, joins a growing list of major international iconic stadium roof projects completed by MakMax Australia and the Tyokogyo Group.
In late 2019, we became involved with John Holland and the architects, Cox, to design the roof for the Sydney Football Stadium. That was a really exciting day for us. It's one of those ones that you remember. Stadiums are like the gold prize, the gold medal of projects around the world. And to be involved is always something that you remember for the rest of your life.
Winning Sydney Football Stadium was a great achievement for us. It's going to be the home of rectangular sports, and some of the major sporting contests will be held there. To have it under a MakMax roof is incredible. For it to be made here in Brisbane is even better, and it's something we're really proud of as a company.
We're a fairly small team within the MakMax team here at Brisbane, so we really all pulled together. It was a very collaborative thing, everyone helping out where we could across the business, so from sales through to a few of the PMs helping out with details and the like. We also pulled in resources from our global network, bounced ideas off them, got feedback.
To communicate effectively between architects, fabricators and other stakeholders, we found ourselves coordinating with a very live 3D model where any changes that were getting made at the front end was able to be carried out instantly and was able to be rebuilt and put together so that we were able to coordinate things very well.
Doing the 3D modelling parametrically meant that we could just apply rules, apply that to the centre line, so that then it could be generated and very quickly changed if any changes to the centre line were made by the client.
With the Sydney Football Stadium, or any large project, there's a lot of repetitive details. No two of those details are the same. They're all just slightly different in geometry or size. And so, not to have any surprises up in there, because everything gets installed on site at 30 metres in air, we made full-scale mock-ups of all those various interfaces to make sure that when we got to site, we'd solve those problems, as well as having some contingencies in hand in case there was something we'd missed.
Something this scale, if you start down the wrong track, you'll very quickly end up with a different answer to what everyone expects, and then it often will be too late when it shows up on site. So it helps to have everyone on the same page at the start.
So durability is a key point for PTFE coated glass fibre fabrics. They're designed to last at least 50 years. And if you compare that to other roofing, translucent roofing elements such as polycarbonate, it's a clear durability advantage. Polycarbonate might last 15 years before needing major maintenance, and a 50-year lifespan is really significant. And when that's coupled with the extremely low maintenance requirements of PTFE roofing, it's a huge win for the project. So the leading edge of the roof was entirely clad in ETFE, just under 4,000 square metres of completely transparent ETFE. It's a technique that's used more and more for major stadium roofs, and it's designed to help promote natural turf growth and reduce the amount of artificial lighting needed to grow the grass through winter and even summertime, depending on the shape of the stands. ETFE is, in its clear, transparent form, 90% light transmission and lets UV through as well, so it's perfect for this kind of application.
The ETFE panels average between 46 metres and 36 metres in the air. In the panels, we had over 1,100 cables that had been installed. So we had a number of guys working from EWPs, working on netting system being developed for this stadium, and also working off the steel gutters.
During the football stadium project, there were a lot of unprecedented challenges involved regarding the scheduling, carrying out delays from weather, unseen events that not only affected us as a team, but affected the coordination and procurement of many of our resources to be able to carry out the work.
With COVID, one of our biggest challenges was lockdowns and travel restrictions. Occasionally there was a situation on site where you'd have guys on site with a problem, weren't sure how to solve it, and because we had some full-scale mock-ups in Brisbane, we could actually work via teams, understand what their problems were and solve those problems here, and therefore and then translate or advise them what the solutions were. No two projects are the same. Each one comes with its own challenges, but it's about having that experience of what could possibly go wrong and making sure that when it does go wrong, you're ahead of the game. You've really planned for that, that scenario. It was challenging. As far as the technical side, it's what we've dealt with before. As far as the pandemic and the wettest year on record, there was definitely a few new challenges thrown in there. We got through it. Awesome product at the end of the day.
Completed in 2022, the Sydney Football Stadium represents the latest of a series of iconic stadium roofing projects by the MakMax Group. We're really proud to have been involved in the Sydney Football Stadium and to add it to our portfolio of structures here in Australia.